So I'm going to go ahead and get started and let Ms. Lori with Donald Trump's campaign come up and speak with us this evening and let her get this started. Excuse me, Lori.
Good evening. I'm Lori Pesta. Like she mentioned, I am from Cherokee County and I am the Donald J. Trump County Chairperson for the Trump campaign. Charlize Bird is the regional director for all these counties in North Georgia, and she had to go to another county tonight, so she asked me to come and step in for her, and I appreciate her confidence. I also want to thank Heather and your board for a great turnout. This is an election year, so you're going to have a good year when it comes to meetings. Meet and greets and politicians all go together. I used to be president of my Republican women's group in Cherokee County, and I was for 5 years, and the most exciting meetings we had were the meet and greets with all the politicians. So there's definitely a reason to for them to come out and keep you informed as voters. And you can share that with your friends and family, because it's important, because a good voter is an informed voter. And that's what's really important in Republican women. We have to keep the public and others in the community informed so that they can vote informed. And a lot of people don't like to do that. They don't want to go to online. They don't want to check out anything. They want information from here to here. So it's always good through the Republican Women, Heather, to keep that going. That's really important. I'm going to share a story with you, if I may. It'll just take a few minutes. Many years ago, I personally went to New York City with a group. In fact, it was a Republican women's group, now that I think about it. And we had a meeting up there in New York City, and one of the activities that we had was basically a fun evening. So a lot of us got together and we went down to the cruise line, and you can take a dinner cruise around Manhattan. And it was really nice because it was at dusk and then it got dark and we had live music and we had dinner on board and, you know, some of those libations that they talk about from time to time. And it was a wonderful time. And as it got dark, you saw all the beautiful Manhattan skyline, all the lights of all the beautiful buildings. It was really spectacular. And if you ever get to go to New York City, make sure that you take the dinner cruise or just a cruise in the evening. But as things progressed through the evening and we were cruising along there, I decided to just go out on the front of the boat. I guess you call that the bow? Okay, good, because I'm not a boat person. I take showers. So I went out on the bow of the boat, and I stood there, and I didn't realize where we were on the river cruise at that point in time. And as I stood there, we slowly started to turn and start our journey back. And as we did, there she was, just as tall and as beautiful and as majestic and enlightened as you can possibly imagine. It was the Statue of Liberty. If you know anything about our freedom, if you know anything about liberty, you cannot go out there and you cannot take that cruise and you cannot stand that close to the Statue of Liberty without being just totally chilled. It was a very emotional moment for me. And it really surprised me because I really don't get too emotional unless it's about the dog. So it really was an emotional time for me. And I will never forget that moment. That was a little victory, I guess you could say, in my life. And it's important that we have these victories. And I hope you all have a victory like that in your life. But when I am here now and I see what's going on with our country now, I really find it difficult to say, where is that moment for me? Where is that moment going to be for your children? Because I don't have any children. Where's that moment going to be for my nieces and nephews and their children? What is going to happen to this country in the future? So personally, I am supporting Donald J. Trump for those little victory moments. I want everyone to continue to have those tear-jerking moments, that reach out and touch Lady Liberty moment. And he can do that, because he's going to keep this country straight. He is going to build a wall that no one's going to get across unless they come through the front door. He's going to stop this nonsense with ISIS. He's going to stop giving our country away. He is going to make strong changes. He is going to make America great again. And that's what we need in this country, so that we can continue to reach out and touch Lady Liberty and feel that freedom and feel that awesome moment in our lives, so that we can continue to pass that awesome feeling down to others. It's about God, it's about our country, it's about our troops, it's about our veterans, it's about everything that we love about this country, and we want to keep it that way. We want to improve it, and we want to make America great again. And I hope you will all come to the polls and vote for Donald J. Trump, so that we can continue to have victories and make America great again. Thank you.